So we talked about the equipment identity register, and its work is to basically store the identities of all the fonts that are marked as valid within the cell. Then the authentication center, still part of the network support subsystem, NSS. The authentication system center is responsible for authentication of a subscriber. It is basically a protected database which stores a copy of the secret key stored in each subscriber's SIM card. This data helps to verify the user's identity. So authentication center deals with the SIM card itself, okay? The SIM card itself. So your SIM card is particular. It's unique. That is why it has a what? It has a PIN, okay? So authentication center basically keeps a record of the details of the subscriber, the details. You see, the equipment identity register keeps the details of the fonts that are there. And those details do not include the name of the owner. They just include the number, the IMEI number, okay? But it is the authentication center that now the mobile subscriber can actually know who owns a particular phone or owns a particular SIM card, okay? Authentication center. All right, then the fourth part of the GSM architecture is what you call the operation and support subsystem. The OSS, the work of the OSS is to control and monitor the GSM systems. Just like any other system, there needs to be a control center. So the OSS is the one that controls and monitors the GSM systems. And for us to be able to understand the OSS better, we need to also know that it also controls the traffic load. It controls the traffic load, how much frequency is the BSS handling per unit time. So it controls the traffic load of the base station controller, okay? Now, when we increase the number of base stations due to development of cellular radio networks, when we increase base stations because we're expanding a network or expanding a cell, then maintenance tasks will be many, because the cells are increasing and the mobile units being supported are increasing, okay? So this particular part of the architecture becomes very important, the operation and support subsystem, especially when we are expanding a network, because its work is basically to do what? To control and monitor so that the base station controller does not get overwhelmed. All right, does not get overwhelmed. So basically, its work is to support the base station controller. Okay. So it monitors and controls the system, the base station controller system, the BSS, the base station system. So functions of the OSS that help to manage the BSS. In other words, the BSS does not have to do those functions, otherwise it is going to be overwhelmed, okay? So the OSS takes up those functions, and by taking up those functions, it basically supports the base station subsystem. So what are these functions that the OSS takes up? The OSS takes up functions like it offers customer cost-effective support functions for centralized, regional, and maintenance activities that are required for a GSM network. Now, what are these customer cost-effective support? For instance, when during a call, there has to be a subsystem within the whole GSM architecture that counts down how much credit you are using. And then when your credit is over, it basically cuts the connection, okay? So it is the operation and support, it's the operation and support subsystem that basically does those particular things. the customer cost effective support, customer cost effective support services, like managing when you are done with your credit. It can actually, when you are done with credit and you are between a call, it cuts the call. All right. Basically, what happens is that when the base station controller does not have to do it, it does not have to monitor your call. Its work is basically to give you a frequency. Okay. And you are now able to connect with someone. Just give you a frequency and manage that frequency. So it keeps that frequency closed. It's like a circuit. It keeps it closed as long as you two are talking and none has hung up. Okay. So that's basically the work of the base station subsystem. But the operation and support subsystem will ensure that the link, when the credit is over, it will tell or it will inform the base station subsystem and the link is going to be cut. So basically the operation subsystem support subsystem basically performs generally the customer cost effective support services. Okay. Now, in GSM, when you are calling somebody, there is a flow. There's a flow sequence when you are calling somebody or you are being called by somebody. Now, when you are calling somebody in the GSM network, basically, there are things that will happen. Okay. The first, and this is called the call flow sequence in the GSM. The call flow sequence in the GSM. Now, when you are calling someone, the first thing that will happen, now don't confuse this with the sequence for monitoring a call. The sequence for monitoring a call when we are talking about base station controllers. Okay, that is about base station controllers, but this GSM. So when you are calling someone, you remember the first one was, you remember the process of connecting and monitoring a call when we are talking about cellular networks. Yeah, we were talking about handshake, we're talking about making a connection. We also talked about, handshake, making a connection, paging, and handoff, those kinds of, you remember those processes. But then here we're talking about the GSM. So when you call someone, first what will happen, there will be location updating. Location updating is basically checking where you are, okay? Checking where you are, and of course using what? Coordinates. Using coordinates, okay? Location updating. So when you are on call, the mobile service, mobile subscriber company can actually know where you are, okay? And also, it has to monitor mobile call origination, all right? So in mobile call origination, we're going to look at what that happens, and then mobile call termination, we're going to see what that is about, authentication, and then inter-MSC cell handoff. So the call flow sequence in GSM involves these particular things: location updating, mobile call origination, mobile call termination, authentication, and inter-MSC cell handoff. So what is location updating? This is a feature that is invoked when an active MS mobile station, like your phone or a tablet, moves from one location or one area to another. All right? One location or one area to another. This is what happens. The MSC sends when you're on a call, okay? When an active MS moves from one location, so when you are on a call or something, the master station controller, the MSC, sends a location update request. When you are moving from one particular area to another, when your phone is on, what it does, the MSC sends a location update request to the visitor location register. Do you remember the visitor location register? So the MSC sends a what? A location update request. to the new visitor location register of the new cell. Okay? Because the visitor location register is the one that stores what? Is the one that stores, a record, a database that stores record of all the cells that are visiting, right? That are changing from one cell to another. So when you are moving with your mobile phone, the MSC, as you're moving from one cell to another, the MSC sends a location update request so that the VLR can update your location, okay? Then the VLR sends location update message to the home location register serving the master station controller, which includes the address of the new VLR and the IMEI of the master of the mobile station. So what you are saying is that now, when the VLR has been informed that there is a new mobile unit or mobile station that is coming into its cell, it sends a location update message to the home location register. Okay, so the home location register can also keep a record of that, can keep a record of that mobile phone. But remember, that record will not stay in the home location register for long. Why? Because if it is a visiting mobile phone and it's normally not there, after that it's going to be removed. Okay, the ones that normally stay in the home location register are the phones that frequently are within that cell, are inside that cell. Okay, so it sends location update message to the HLR, and which includes the address of the new visitor location register and also the IMEI, the identifier of that phone. Okay, then what happens in number three in location updating is the service and security related data for the mobile station is sent back to the VLR. Service is what is that mobile phone doing currently? Is it texting? Is it WhatsApping? Is it things that are related to communication, not things like playing music, that is not related to communication. Things related to communication, like texting, calling, WhatsApping, or you are using the internet, okay? So what services are being used by that particular phone, and also what are the security details related to your mobile station? And some of your security details are your mobile phone, the SIM card, what? The SIM number, because your SIM has a unique number. That's why you have to put a PIN number. So your SIM has a unique number with which it is identified. So the service details and the security details are now sent back to the visitor location register. So the visitor location register now has what? The IMEI of your phone, the services you're using at that particular time when you're changing location, and also the security details of your phone, like your SIM card number. Then when the VLR now has those three sets of information about your phone, it sends acknowledgement of successful update. So it cannot acknowledge that it has successfully updated the details of your phone if it doesn't have those three sets of data, the IMEI, the security details, and the service details. Then the HLR requests the old VLR to delete data related to the mobile station. So the home location register of the previous, okay? The home location register of the previous cell is now, it requests the old VLR, the old visitor location register, if you moved from another cell also. So you move from one cell to another cell to another cell. So the old VLR is requested by the HLR to delete data that belongs to that phone, meaning that you are now not in that particular cell. You're in this particular cell that now holds your data in its VLR, the visitor location register. Okay. So that is more location updating. When you are changing location, the first thing that happens, the master station controller sends a location update request to the VLR. Then the VLR sends a location update message to the new VLR. Okay, the VLR of the old sends an update message to the new VLR, which includes the IMEI of your phone. Then after that, two other information are now sent to the new VLR, the services that phone is using and the security details of that phone. After the new VLR has got those three sets of information about your phone, Now it does what it acknowledges it as a successful update. And then the old VLR is requested by the new VLR to do what? To delete the information about your phone. Okay, meaning that now you have moved to another cell. Then mobile call origination. Let me see how much we have to cover. Anyway, mobile call origination. So what happens? Mobile call origination, when you are calling someone, these particular things happen. When you're calling someone, these particular things happen. The master station sends the dialed number indicating service requested to MSC. The mobile station, the phone, it sends the dialed number, right? Indicating the service requested. What is the service requested? Call. A call is a service, okay? Just as texting is a service, all right? Then the MSC checks from the VLR if the mobile station is allowed the request service. So the mobile station, the master station controller checks from the visitor location register if that mobile phone of yours is allowed the requested service. And what determines if you are allowed to call? Number one, if you have credit, right? Number two, if the other person is available. So if the other person is available, then the connection will be established. If they're not available, then the call request will be denied, okay? So if call is allowed, the master station controller routes call to the global master station controller. The global master station controller is basically managed by global satellites, such that now when you are calling, you can actually be detected from anywhere in the world if it is necessary. So you are able to be detected from anywhere in the world. Okay? And the global master station controller routes the call to the local exchange of the called user. All right? So the called user is now able to pick your call. Then there is an alert which applies ringing in the call terminal. So the person you are now calling will see the phone ringing. There will be a dialing alert, okay? And then the person being called can answer back, okay? And then when the answer back signal is routed back to the mobile station. So now you're able to do back and forth communication. So this is how mobile call origination happens. When you're calling someone, that request, calling is a request. So you are placing a request on the master station controller. So the master station controller handles that request. Then when that request has been allowed, meaning that probably you have credit and also the other person is available, then your call is transferred to the global master station controller so that during your call, you are actually detectable from anywhere within the world, okay? From anywhere within the world. And then when that happens, the global master station controller hands over the call to the local master station controller, all right? Hands over back the call to the local master station controller. And then when the local master station controller has now your call, it is able to channel your call to the other user, okay? Exchange of called user, okay? Then it applies a ringing to the call terminal. So the person being called now, he has the phone being rung, the phone ringing. And then he answers back. And then when he answers back, he's receiving the call. When he receives the call, then there is now a back and forth communication. Signals are now routed back to the mobile station. So now there's a back and forth, okay? And then mobile call termination, remember what we are discussing. Remember we are discussing the call flow sequence in GSM, okay? So the first one is when you are moving around, you're moving around. Then the second one is when you are calling. Then after calling is when you terminate. So what happens when a call is terminated? Mm-hmm. So particular things happen, okay? Particular things happen here, but let me see. Just a minute. Just a minute. All right. So let me share screen. So mobile call termination. What happens? So there are different initials that we are going to use here. The first one is what we call the PSTN. The PSTN is basically the public switched telephone network. The public switched telephone network is basically the collection of interconnected voice-oriented public telephone networks. It's the collection of all the interconnected voice-oriented public phone networks. Now, basically, when, let me see, okay, all right. When you are during a call, the PSTN user, the person that is using the mobile phone, dials this particular standard, the MSISDN. The MSISDN basically stands for the Mobile Station International Subscriber Directory Number. It's basically a number used to identify a mobile phone. It's just like the IMEI, okay? And it includes a country code and a national destination code, okay? So basically, the IMEI basically contains the unique number for your phone. But the mobile station, the MSISDN, contains the details of that phone, including the country code, like +254, all right? The country code, like the country code for countries +254, okay? So the use of the phone dials this particular standard, which therefore recognizes which country they are in, right, of the person they are calling, okay? The country of the person, the person being called, okay? The MSISDN of the person being called, all right? And then when it identifies the code number of the country being called, when it identifies the code number of the country being called, it routes the call. It routes the call to the global master station controller of the called user. So it routes the call just the same way we routed the call here. The master station, when the call is allowed, the master station controller routes the call to the global master station controller. So here it also routes the call of the number which is in another, probably another nation or another country, it routes the call to the GMSC, that call. All right. Then the GMSC uses the dialed country code to determine the home location register for the GSM user. So the GMSC, the Global Master Station Controller, uses the country code of that phone that is being called to determine the home location register of the user that is being called, okay? Then the home location register requests the current serving VLR for called mobile station for a roaming number, right? So that the call can be routed to the correct master station controller. Now, don't worry about these. These are just basically telecommunication terminologies, okay? Telecommunication terminologies. So the HLR, the home location register, requests the current serving VLR for the called mobile station for a roaming number so that the call can be routed to the correct master station controller. Why is that important? That is important because this GSM user is probably in another country that has a different MSISDN, okay, and a country code, a different country code. Then the visitor location register passes the roaming number to the home location register. And the home location register passes the roaming number to the GMSC. So it's like going down and then going up from the GMSC to the local MSC and from the MSC to the global MSC. Okay. And then using the roaming number, the global MSC routes the call to the serving mobile station controller, then the master station controller. Then the master station controller checks the visitor location register for current location area identity, location area to verify the identity of the mobile. I think I missed to include that, to verify the identity for the master station controller. Then when that happens, the VLR provides current location for the mobile station. And then the master station controller pages. What is paging? Paging is basically updating. Okay, it pages the mass mobile station via appropriate base station controller. So we have moved from mobile master station controller from number 3 to number 7. This is basically the operations of the master station controller during call termination. To now, the what? The base station controller, which is now the one that assigns a frequency for the user that is being called. And then the master station responds to the page and sets up the necessary signaling links. Then the base station has established now the necessary radio links. The radio links is just a channel. A radio link is a channel or a frequency. And then the master station controller is informed and the call is delivered to the mobile station. And then when the mobile answers the call, connection is completed to calling the PSTN, basically the voice, the collection of voice interconnected voice users. Okay. So basically, I know that this is a little bit hard to swallow, but I encourage you to basically read. And this is what I'm going to encourage you to do. I'm going to encourage you to look for this particular. Terms, the PSTN, the MSISDN. But of course, I've already explained that the PSTN is basically, I've said that the PSTN is basically the what? It's what you call the public switched telephone network. So basically, it's an interconnection of all the voice-oriented mobile phones. And the MSISDN is what? It's basically the Mobile Station International Subscriber Directory number. And it's a number used to identify the country code of a particular phone or a particular SIM card. The country code. So when you learn more about this and is you are able to understand now when what every other thing here is. I know it's a little bit hard to swallow for here, but you're going to understand if you dig deeper into the PSTN and the MSISDN. But I don't want you to go too deep into the details of how they work. Just know that the PSTN is the interconnection of all the voice-oriented devices like your phones, and then the MSISDN is just the country code of a particular subscriber. All right, Okay, so when you understand that, you are now able to understand how all of these work. So we have 5 minutes. Let me see. We have 5 minutes remaining, meaning that we have done 1 hour plus. So let's just stop it at that so that at least you can find time to absorb what we have learned, especially the last item here, the mobile call termination, so that you can get time to absorb and probably to ask, to interrogate things that we have learned. All right. And so when we come back in the next class, we are going to look at authentication and encryption, and then also handoff in GSM. And then after that, we are going to look at something called location management. But of course, when we come back, we're going to be fresh. We're going to be ready so that we can absorb more. But just apart from when this is over, authentication and encryption and handoff, the rest becomes easy. GSM services becomes very, very easy. So let's call it a class. there are some particular things that are needed of me, so I'm going to end the class so that I respond and I give clarification for some certain things that are required of me by the school. So let's call it a class at that point. Have yourselves a nice time. Of course, we shall meet in the other class. Have a good day.